The Somerville Library System has a new leader at the helm. Glenn Ferdman recently came on board as Director of Library Services from Park University in Missouri. Ferdman brings over 20 years of experience with him, having worked in everything from medical libraries to university settings. SNN News Director Heather Avison recently sat down with him. Here's an excerpt from their conversation.
I'm Heather Avison here at Somerville Community Access Television, and I'm very pleased to introduce to you today Glenn Ferdman, the new Director of Libraries here in the city of Somerville. Welcome, Glenn.
Thank you.
So tell us a little bit about yourself.
Sure. I have a master's degree in library science from Indiana University. I'm a native of Chicago. I've been working in the library profession for about 25 years. I often refer to myself as a library mutt because there's virtually no library environment that I haven't worked in, be it school library, academic library, public library. My first professional position, as a matter of fact, was at a law firm library.
Hmm. What do you bring as your first priority that you would like to see move forward?
Well, one of the first things I've been doing is getting to know the staff, establishing and building those relationships, learning about what it is that we do on a more granular scale in terms of the services that we offer, the programs that we do, the collections.
When you talk about the locality of a branch and gearing it towards that demographic, how does that fit into the bigger picture of the future of libraries?
You know, in terms of the trends, current trends and best practices in public libraries, similar to academic libraries, actually, in creating open spaces, technology-rich spaces, flexible spaces that could be used for a variety of purposes, whether it be group individual study, meeting spaces, collaborative type of work, with furniture that can be easily arranged and rearranged for a variety of different purposes, lots of places to plug in because increasingly people are bringing their devices with them to the library. And of course, I get asked this question a lot, books will never go away.
In my mind,
there's this marriage between the print and the digital. I see them as coexisting as opposed to being these oppositional forces. Now, having said that, it's true. If you look at, statistically speaking, libraries across the board, whether they happen to be public or academic libraries, the trend is in the last several years that circulation of print materials is going in this direction, whereas circulation and usage of electronic books and related resources is going like this. Having said that, at the same time, there's still and will always be, at least I hope there will be, a demand for print resources. It's a question of, you know, finding the right mix.
Tell me about your favorite childhood memory from the library.
Oh gosh, well, just going there is a safe place to go, a quiet place to read and to explore. You know, that's another reason why I hope, do everything in my power to prevent print books from going away. It's that serendipity factor, just getting lost in the stacks and wandering, right? And coming across stuff that you never would have had you not had that ability. But I don't think anything, any digital environment can truly replicate that experience of just wandering through and getting lost in the stacks. And then, you know, you look at your watch and hours have gone by and before you know it.
So I encourage everyone to visit the library, say hello to the new director, and thank you.
Thanks so much.
And welcome.
Thank you. Pleasure.
The Somerville Public Library System has summer reading programs for children and teens. Visit their website at somervillepubliclibrary.org or stop in at your local branch for more information. The West Library branch is located in Davis Square, the East Library branch on Lower Broadway, and the Central Library on Highland Avenue, adjacent to the high school. You can view the entire interview with Glenn Ferdman at scattvsomerville.org.